Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Your name is exalted forever. Oh. Sit down, pray in tongues. Pray in tongues. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. To you belong all power, Jesus. Whenever I call your name, you make a way. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. Let's sing it quietly. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. To you belong all power, Jesus. Whenever I call your name, yeah, you make a way. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. Let's try it again one last. A strong tower, Jesus. To you belong all power, Jesus. Whenever I call your name, you make a way. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. Let's try it, everybody, everybody, everyone. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. Come on now. To you belong all power, Jesus. Whenever I call your name, you make a way. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. Let's try for the last time. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. To you belong all power, Jesus. Whenever I call your name, you make a way. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. I'm going to be speaking this morning and praying this morning. Emphasis that the Lord has given us is that we'll come into a sharpened sensitivity. That our sensitivity or our discernment will be sharpened this year. Acts 16:16, there was a young girl crying after Paul, I think, and the disciples, she was chorusing around with them, behold the man that brings to us God's word. All right, now. And it came to pass, as we went to prayers, a certain damsel possessed with a spirit of divination met us, which brought her masters much gain by soothsaying. What happened? The same followed Paul and us and cried, saying, these men are the servants of the Most High God, which show unto us the way of salvation. See the man that has come to show us the way of salvation. And this she did for many days. Many days means she did it for more than one day. I'm sure if she did it for 2 days, it would have told us 2 days. Many means it was many. She did this for what? Many days. But Paul being grieved. That's the emphasis. What's the difference between what she did the first day, the second day, the third day, and many days? What was different that day when Paul was grieved in his spirit, turned and said to the spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out the same hour. So how did Paul tolerate that spirit for many days? But one day became grieved in the spirit. I said this morning that not everything that looks good, appears good, is God. Are we here? That it is correct does not mean it is God. Her message was correct. See the men that shows us the way of salvation. Correct message, wrong source. I must make bold and clearly stated here that the supernatural is not just for the church. The supernatural is for the world. The supernatural is not just for the believer. The supernatural is for everyone that cares to tap into it. There's a world beyond this world, and only people that can access that world can prevail. Only people that can access that world can reign. This girl was getting her information from another world. This girl was being supernatural. But Paul had to step into another realm to counter that realm. The war we are facing and the war we are fighting is not in this realm. It's from another place. And many times we are not even wise enough to know that the instructions will not come from here. The instruction will come from that place where this war is raging. Are you still here with me? Okay? So I'm going to just speak briefly, and by the way, the Spirit of God will have us share, so that we can prepare our heart. Amen? John 10. John is speaking in John 10, and he's saying in John 10, I think in verse 16, first of all, in verse 16. John 10, verse 16. And other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, them also I must bring. And they shall hear my voice. Underline the word hear. They shall hear my voice, because they will come into one fold and they will have one shepherd, one pastor. That shepherd is Jesus. That pastor is Jesus. This is the fold. This is his church. He said that this church, we are called into this church as sheep. As what? Sheep. He said the number one requirement of the sheep is that the sheep must hear. The sheep must hear. The sheep must hear. My sheep must hear. Jump to 26. I think, is it 26 or 27? 27 now explains it. Look at 27. My sheep hear my voice. My sheep hear my voice. One of the first things that we like to teach when we teach on spiritual things is the ability to hear God's voice. For some folks, it is strange. It is strange. They don't know what it means to hear God's voice. They don't know what it means to hear God's voice. They don't know what it means. It's strange. When people say, God said to me, it's strange. It's not only strange, sometimes it is big. It's big when you say, God spoke to me. How can the Almighty God communicate to you? Which ear did you use to hear it? Glory to God. But the instruction is clear, my sheep hears my voice. It means that if you are a sheep, you will hear his voice. And many times the sheep, the voice of the shepherd is not loud. Is somebody in church this morning? Sometimes the voice of the shepherd is not loud. I grow young men in the ministry, and I have a lot of them around me. And many times when we are around like this, I don't talk, but I talk. Sometimes that's how we raise our children also. We don't talk, but we talk. There are things you don't say on the table with your mouth. Your children just look at your eyes and realize that daddy is talking. You just look at them like this. This look means I'll kill you today. You know that kind of look? You are dead. Put it in your mouth and die. Then they just drop it. Why? Because they are children and they have come to recognize. So one of the key words in the word, hear my voice, is recognize. The word discern means to recognize. It means to judge correctly. It means to distinguish. And I said in the first service that our key into 100% success in life, success in anything we do, is discernment. It's discernment. You can't discern, you can't win. You can't discern, you can't win. Meaning you don't know, you don't win. Psalms 46, I think it's in verse 10. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among other options. How would you know I'm God? Be still. Meaning that many times this discernment comes with quietness. So it means that Paul over time became quiet in his spirit. Then he could filter the voice of God from the voice of that damsel. And for many of us, like I said this morning, is that we are too busy. Your life is too noisy. Hear me loud, somebody, prophetically, I will need to tell you this, that you may need to reduce the activity around your life this year. Activity does not mean productivity. That you are busy does not mean you are being productive. You are everywhere does not mean you are making sense. You are everywhere doesn't mean you are making impact. Be at the places where God wants you to be, you will make more impact. Say the things God wants you to say, it will make more sense. Your life is too busy. Thus saith the Lord. Your life is too busy. Reduce the activities around your life. I want to talk to you. I want to speak to you. The Lord is calling many people into moments of meetings. I want to speak to you. But you see, it's one thing for God to speak. It's another thing for you to hear. To hear again means to understand. It means to understand. Again, that's where the word discern comes from. Discern. Discern. Proverbs 20 verse 27. The spirit of man is the candle of the Lord, and he searcheth the bellies of the earth. Meaning that how man used to search things out is by the candle of the Lord. That candle of the Lord is the Spirit of God. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. It has not entered into the hearts of men what God has in store for them who love him. But he has revealed it to us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things. Yea, the Spirit searcheth even the deep things of God. If the Spirit can search God, the Spirit can search man. If the Spirit can bring God into knowing, then it can bring man into knowing. Many of you walk with thieves, you walk with robbers, you walk with kidnappers, you don't know. Why will you not know? Many of you have made investment in business that will crash in the first 4 months of this year. Why would you not know? Am I talking to someone? How do I put my hard-earned money in a business that will crash and God won't tell me? You don't tell me God didn't tell you. God told you. But you were too busy with profits to know what God was saying. And you see, that's the dangers of profit. Once you put your money here, 4 months, you cash out. That thing called cash out used to pause your spirit. God is telling you, you are not cashing out anything. Then somebody calls that, they just paid me. They send you screenshot. They send you fake screenshot. And you still cannot know how dull are you. How dull can a believer be? That you don't know this is a thief. Nothing annoys me most than working with dull people. Blinded people. Ruled by natural senses. Ruled by external things. Why did you borrow her the money? The way she asked me, she was just, you did not know. Anybody can get anything out of you by just making you feel pity for them. You did not know. You are a spirit man. Am I talking to somebody here? You are a spirit man. It means that firstly this year, we must come to recognize who we truly are. That we are spirit beings. How dare a man, a mortal man, cheat a spirit being? You don't understand what I'm saying. How dare a mortal man cheat a spirit being? A mortal man outplayed you. Wow. A mortal man born of a woman outplayed you, born of the spirit. God forbid. Not this year. Not this year. It comes by simple discipline. How can I be still and know I will give more attention to the Spirit this year? I'll give more attention to the Spirit this year. I'll give more attention to recognize the Spirit's voice, recognize the movements of the Spirit. You know, Precious read the scripture from us in Samuel just now when he said, you shall see the movement of the mulberry tree. Because in the Old Testament, it was important that God communicate to them via outward witness. Outward witness. So David must need look at the mulberry tree. And once you see that it's moving, know that God is doing something. It will move without wind. But you must see it. So he's watching to see it. Abraham will take the blood. And they will go yonder to worship. But he will not be told the mountain. Because he will need to see the mountain. The instruction is upon the mountain I will show you. I'm not telling you the mountain. I will show you. So as he's traveling through the desert, he'll be looking at the mountain. What is he looking for? There must be an activity upon that mountain that nobody else could have seen. Am I talking here this morning? All of the prophets, all of them were walking by natural sight. But their feelings were involved in what they were doing. Then God says to us in the New Testament, I will not walk with you in that same path. I will walk with you from inside. We have not just received the Spirit upon, we have received the Spirit within. So now God is not speaking to us by externals. And I tell you this without any fee. If you are still walking with God by externals, you are cheating yourself. You are cheating yourself. The way God wants us to walk with him is by what is called the inner weakness. The inner weakness is very powerful. What God is saying to you inside, what God is saying to you inwardly. As you are sitting here right now, there are communications of the Spirit. Do I have a weakness? There are communications of the Spirit. That no matter how loud the word is sounding, there's something you are hearing. You are trained like that. You are trained that way, that no matter who is shouting, I know when God is talking. I know when God is talking. No matter who is shouting, I don't move by things walking. His walking is not how I move. He must talk. He's a talking God. He's not just a great thing kind of God. One of the great things he does is that he talks. But many times we are too dull to know that it's God that is talking. He speaks to me. This year I'm giving attention to him speaking to me. Speak to me, Lord, your servant hears. Speak to me, Lord, your servant hears. My ears are open 24/7 to hear what you are saying. My eyes are open 24/7 to see what you are showing. Because you are always showing. You are always talking. People don't just hear. People don't just see. He said to Isaac, stay in the land. So here. The man would have traveled and died. But guess what? Instruction. He knew it that he was to stay here. That's what the homie's husband didn't know. Right? Was that his name again? Naomi's husband. Is it Naomi? Is it Naomi? Yeah, it's Naomi. Took Naomi and took his two sons and traveled to Moab. Why? Because he found that there was no bread in Jerusalem. He allowed his external to speak to him. No bread in Jerusalem? Are you that dumb? Jerusalem is the house of bread. If there's no bread today, there will be no bread tomorrow. It's called the house of bread. There may seem not to be bread now. Doesn't mean bread will ever be short in Jerusalem. It's called house of bread. Who runs away from the house of bread to Moab? Moab is a fallen city caused by God. You are running from here to get help where God has left. He didn't know. Lost his life, lost his two sons, then came back to Jerusalem only to find that there's bread in Jerusalem. Elimelech, right? There's bread in Jerusalem. Came back and found that there was bread. But only that she came without a husband and without sons. Because they lack discernment. Quickest way to die as a spirit man is to lack discernment. Quickest way to failure as a spirit man is to lack discernment. Is to lack discernment. Quickest way for people to pull you down is to enjoy their praise and not discern their heart. You see this praise of man? Man will always praise you. But does not mean that man really means to praise you. If you can't discern the heart of man, you will enjoy praise to your detriment. They will praise you, then say at your back, Siam. May your eyes be open to such men. May your eyes be open to such men. That this year you will know who to talk to and who not to talk to. By discernment, you will know that I won't spend much time with this person. Every time I spend time with this person, I realize I run out. I mean, they are joy killers. How come you didn't know that every time you spoke with this person, something happened to your joy? Every time you talk with this person, you became more natural. Every time. And the other people, every time you spend 1 minute with them, it's like iron sharpening iron. How come you didn't discern it? That these are men to stay with more and detach from these other men. Because let me tell you, like I said this morning in the morning service, and I said by the Spirit, it's coming again. There are men appointed to your detriment this year. There are men appointed to your downfall this year. It is how it has been planned. That they will drain you this year. And the enemy has already placed them strategically. Even men of the devil know that they have been used of the enemy. They don't know. They don't know, even you don't know. But this year, as we come close to God and bend our ears to his mouth, we shall hear him say to us, this is the way to go. This is the way to go. These are the men to walk with. These are the people to live with. This is the place to stay. You will hear him say. I feel God is interested in every part of our lives. But we are not just disciplined enough to wait for his voice. So you see what we are praying for this week? We are praying for a discerning spirit. A discerning spirit. Romans 14:1, it talks about disputes. Dispute. Men that bring contentions. Men that bring argument. Him that is weak in the faith, receive ye, but not toward what? A doubtful disputation. If that doubtful disputation talks about the ability to discern matters. It's discerning matters. That there are certain matters that will come as you are talking, the Spirit will tell you withdraw. There are certain things happening. You have information to put your mouth. As you are putting your mouth, you will hear the Spirit tell you withdraw. I've not called you for such contributions. It's not everything that goes on social media that you talk. It's not. It tells me how insensitive people are to the Spirit. When every matter is their matter. Sir, every matter is not our matter. This year, I want to know the wars to fight. I want to know matters to address. I want to know people to come with, to gather around. So that I can spend less time with wasters. Am I talking to someone? Oh, I'm telling you this. It's part of the way your increase will come. How did he increase? By simple instruction, stay in the land, sow in it. Go and read the story. He increased steadily and he became very great that even the owners of the land started envying him. That's increased steadily and exceedingly. How did you become bigger than landlord? Just by hearing, my sheep shall hear my voice. Would you pray a prayer with me as you are sitting down right now? Lord, open my ears to your voice. I want you to pray. And you see what I'm talking to you right now? I am very serious. I want to open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. I need everybody, open your mouth and pray. I want to hear your voice. I can hear you pray. Ooh, shada bahatia. Iloboroti barataya. Where's Pastor Jesus? I'm looking for your voice, sir. Pray in tongues. Give Pastor Jesus the mic. We came for prayer. It's a prayer meeting. It's a prayer meeting. It's a prophetic meeting. It's a time to hear God in the beginning of the year. It's called prayer and strategy. Pray. I'm giving you a strategy now. I'm giving you a strategy. It's discernment. It's discernment. Open your mic up, please. Pray. I will not be careless with your voice. I will not be careless. I will correctly judge. This is how we win. We know what God is saying. We know what God is saying. I always know what God is saying. I always know what God is saying. I always know what God is saying. Would you squeeze the person's hand to your right and to your left if you can and pray? I'm praying for you that this year you will always know what God is saying. This year you will always know what God is saying. You will not be void of the voice of God. You will not be void of the voice of God. Put your hands in your ears. Using it as a point of contact for your spiritual ears. My ears are open. We activate hearing. We activate hearing. We activate hearing. May your spiritual ears be open. May your spiritual ears be open. I activate hearing this morning. I activate hearing this morning. Blast open. Blast open. You that have never heard God, your ears are open now. You that have never heard God. Never heard God. But this morning your ears are open. You hear. You hear. You hear. All of those cobwebs, they leave you now. You know when God is talking. Look at me. Part of the sounding is seen also. It has to do with recognize. It has to do with recognizing what God is doing. Recognizing men. Recognizing places. Abraham recognized that was that place where Isaac must be sacrificed. Do you know the danger of Abraham not recognizing that it was the place to sacrifice Isaac? Because that place where the Lord showed him will be the place where the ram is caught in the ticket. Meaning once you miss the place of sacrifice, you will miss the offerings of the Lord. Do you know what it means to have appeared on a strange mountain? Then God says, don't kill the child. And you can't hear because he's talking on that mountain. Ooh. It has to not be talking on the mountain where I appear. If not, he will talk, I will not hear. It will not be that he did not talk, it's that I didn't appear on the right mountain. That God will spotlight people and places for you this year. Look at what I'm telling you so you can pray well. Abraham sent Eliezer to get a wife for his son. The man prayed a simple prayer. He had not finished praying. It was in the same place where he prayed it that the answer of the prayer showed up. Meaning that, look at his prayer, that you will lead me. You will lead, it has to do with leading first. You will lead me to a place where I will meet somebody that I will require the person to give me water. The person will not only give me water, but give my camel water. And God was answering it instantly. It's called right place, right time. Right place, right time. Right place, right time. Would you pray for 1 minute? Lord, this year, I appear in right place, right time. Right. Where are the people that came to church this morning? Where are the people that came to church with their faith this morning? Right place, right time. I can feel this church this morning. Right place. Right place. Right place. Right place. I appear right places. Right place. This is how we win. 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 By the leadings of the Spirit. Are you praying? Right place. Right place. Right time. Right place. Right place. Right place. Right time. Lift your voice. Right place, right time, right place. Would you hold somebody? Pray again for the person. Hold someone and pray. You are here. Right place, right time. Right place, right time. Right place. Right place. Right place. Right place. Right place.
Sit down. Look at me.
I need us to press into it. Right place, right time. Right place, right time. All this, sorry. If you had come 5 minutes ago. Oh, if you had come yesterday. Oh, the last one we had, we just gave it out just now. No, no, not for me, not for me, not for me. I'm the one that take the last ones. I'm the one that take the choice place. As I'm going to the supermarket, when there is no place to park, so all of a sudden, somebody is leaving for me to park. Right place, right time. Right place, right time. When they are going to reward somebody, that's the time I appeared. When this was going to come, that's the time I appeared. I always appear on time. Can you pray for yourself with your hand on your head? I appear on time. Oh, suppose you came last month. That's my portion. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He's leading and directing my path. He's leading and directing my path. He's leading me to where pastures are. At the same times, at the same moments, at the same seasons. There are 14 persons here. What I'm going to say relates to 14 of you. God is calling you into moments. And in this year, you will feel hands beckoning on you. You will feel that hand. And I sense in my spirit supernaturally, there's going to be a move of the spirit towards that direction. You will feel his hand beckon on you. He will tap you to wake up. He will tap you to move. You will feel it. You will feel that hand of God. This year. You will feel the beckoning power of God. Tapping you to respond to his word. Tapping you to do what he's saying. For you is like an assurance. I'm the one talking to you. I'm the one. Your heart is telling you. But now I'm telling you too. Let your body tell you I'm the one talking to you. And as I'm talking to these 14 people right now, the manifestation of the Spirit is around them now. Can we pray for 2 minutes? The manifestation, the presence of God is around these 14 persons. Tangibly. There are 14 of them. Tangibly, the power of God is around them. And they can feel it strong. Holy Spirit, thank you. The 14 of you, I hear my presence will go with you. And that's what you're feeling now. My presence is going with you. My presence. Moses, help them. My presence is going with you. My presence. I will lead you in the right path. We are the
just want to be where you are.
Let's just enjoy sweet worship. Let God do what he wants to do.
Dwell and dwell in your presence. I just want to worship from my heart. Draw me near to where you are.
I want to be in your presence.
I want to be where you are. Dwelling in your presence.
Feasting at your table.
Feasting at your table.
Surrounded.
Surrounded by your glory. In your presence. That's where I always want to be. Oh, I just want to be. Just want to be with you.
Lift your hands, everybody. Sing it one more time. I want to be.
I want to be where you are.
Now follow me now. Come on now.
Dwelling in your presence.
Feasting at your table.
Feasting at your table.
Surrounded by your glory.
Surrounded by your glory.
You are his battle axe. You are for this season. He said, I'm calling you for this season. Because in this season, there are people that your life will be witnessed to. You went through what you went through, and you came out of it because you'll be a light to these people. You'll be a light to witness to them of the things that I took you through and how I brought you up. That's why you went through that season. You become a testimony to many others. And you bring deliverance. I see you bringing deliverance their way. I see people that want to attempt suicide. Come out of that attempt because of you. It's God's work in your life. Lord, I want to know you.
Swelling in your presence.
I want to know you more. I want to know you. Would you make that a prayer right now, everybody? Lord, I want to know you. This year, I want to know you more. I know your voice. I know the things you are saying. Come on, pray. My sons was going to meet with a client, one of the big men in Sapley. I had spoken words over him. As he was going, he saw a shop and saw a shirt. For no reason, he stopped to buy the shirt. So he bought the shirt and wore the shirt and went for that meeting. Guess what? He bought the fake of the original the man was wearing the same day. As he entered the office, the man laughed. I said, we are wearing uniform. It was fake, obviously. But big men don't know fake. That he was wearing that shirt was all that he needed to get the contract. They did not talk again. They didn't talk. Inside the information, buy it, wear it, wear that color. Don't wear that color. I've had people that entered the interview and the panel was hostile with them because chairman don't like red. You wore red. You wore red. So everything was red for you. They were asking you. He was hostile to you. He doesn't like you because of what you're wearing. It's discernment. The servant tells us what to put on, how to put it on. When we are appearing before the king, you will hear a voice tell you, shave. Clean, clean, clean up, clean up. Don't go with this hair. Don't go with this hair. This hair will not do it. It may look unimportant, but that may just be the edge. You have the communion in your hand. Lord, that my heart will be drawn towards yours. You are the one that knows everything. If you know everything and my ears are close to your heart, I will know what you know. Let my ears in the spirit be near thee, Lord. Can you pray that prayer? Then we'll sing Draw Me Nearer. Then we'll take the communion. Pray. Pray. Would you pray? 1 minute. 1 minute, just pray. Now look at me. Look at me. I want us to be as real with ourselves as we can. How many of you feel moments in your life when you just know that it looks like the Lord is far from you? You've had that kind of moment? You just feel it. That it looks like I should separate myself. Like God is just far. There are moments like that. It's not like God is far. No. It's that your flesh is becoming too loud. And the Spirit of God is trying to bring to your notice what is wrong. One of the obstructors of discernment is flesh. One of the things that obstructs your knowing is flesh. So I gave it in the way of instruction this morning. This year, eat little. Eat light. Sleep light. Talk little. Talk little. The Spirit wants to appear in your room and tap you. And you won't have to fall everything to get your attention to wake up. His appearance in your room will wake you up. John said, the Spirit, Ezekiel said, he took me by the Spirit and landed me upon the valley of dry bones. You need to be flexible, light, for the Spirit of God to lift you and take you where he wants you to take, where he wants to take you. You need to. And many times, that flexibility comes as we give more attention to waiting on the Lord. For they that wait upon the Lord will exchange their strength. That word renew is the word exchange. We take his strength. We relinquish ourselves of our own strength and pick up his strength. They exchange their strength. He said, they mount up with wings as eagles. They run, they are not tired. They walk, they are not weary. Why? They are waiting on the Lord. Lift that communion up. Let's sing that song.
Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord.
Everybody, do you have the full
to the cross?
Let's sing the full one.
Where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, blessed Lord, to thy precious leading side.
Everybody, I am dying, oh Lord. Everyone.
I am dying, oh Lord. I have heard the voice and it's told love to me.
But I long to rise.
But I long to rise.
In the arms of faith.
In the arms of faith.
I'll be closer.
I'll be closer. Drawn to thee.
Everybody, draw me nearer.
Draw me nearer. Blessed Lord, to thy cross where thou hast died. Jesus.
Everybody pray the Holy Ghost. Pray the Holy Ghost. Pray. 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 Pray the Holy Ghost. You have made a request. You have made a request. Pray. Pray. Rato Santa Barabata said, Rato Santa, 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 Rato Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, 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 thank you for your revival. Thank you for your rebuilding of fire in our lives. Eat.
Run out to me quickly. You're giving your tithe. Run out to me quickly. Everyone keep praying. Everyone keep praying. You're giving your tithe. Run out to me quickly. Pray. I speak the blessing of the Lord over you. Increase come for you. In the name of Jesus. I speak increase. Increase for you. In the name of Jesus. Increase for you. Increase for you. Increase for you. In the name of Jesus. Exceedingly, increase steadily, increase exceedingly in the name of Jesus. Increase steadily, increase exceedingly. Take out your offerings quickly. The accounts are on the screen. Take out your offerings quickly. Take out your offerings. Keep praying. Don't stop praying. Do your transfers quickly. Do it quickly. Do it quickly. Do it.